Now we've got Favor Itua, who is joining us all the way from Cote d'Ivoire. Favor, good to have you with us. What's the update over there in Abidjan?
Bonjour, Udoka Njoku. Bonjour to the guys in the studio, Anito and John. Interestingly, today is match day, the day that, of course, Nigeria will take on Cameroon right here in the city of Abidjan. As we speak, tickets are being given to Nigerian supporters who have come all the way from Nigeria, courtesy of the Nigerian Football Federation. They are trying to settle the tickets. And of course, at the moment, some of the tickets are going for as low as 10,000 CFA. That's about 20,000 Naira. And, you know, that's to show you how much of, importance and big this game is, because, of course, you know, the tickets are going for a high. And fans are optimistic. The good thing about Abidjan is the fact that the population right here has many of Nigerians based here. It forms half of the population we have here in Abidjan. So we're expecting to see more supportership from those resident here in Abidjan and those, of course, you know, that have traveled all the way from Nigeria to this part. So far, so good. It's going on. It's building up gradually as the Felix Ofori Bwanyi Stadium is expected to be filled with fans from Nigeria and, of course, for Cameroon, who also have a community right here in Ajame. In Ajame, we have the Nigerian community, we have the Cameroon community, and we don't know who, of course, Cote d'Ivoire will support, knowing fully whether they speak French with the Cameroonians.
Right, now, what is the update coming from the Super Eagles camp? I know they've had their training sessions. Cameroon has also had their training sessions. What is the feeling like from the camp of the Super Eagles?
All right, the feeling in camp of Super Eagles, the mood is very, very high. The players are optimistic. For what we saw in training, it was a full training session from the players of the Super Eagles, as we did not have any issues of injuries. Alassane Youssouf had full training session, Truce Ekon also had opportunity to train in full, amongst those that did not have that full training session before Guinea-Bissau game. So there's no cause for worries. And the journalists, of course, asked Joseph Peseiro if Kelechi Iheanacho will be included. I mean, a lot of persons talked about the statistics of the young man who, of course, in the last five matches have had, you know, goals than, you know, some of the players in the team. He did say that he came into the camp injured. He's going to take a gradual step, but he assured us that Kelechi Iheanacho would be involved in today's game. But we don't, of course, know if he's going to start with the Leicester City man. So the boys know what is at stake. Lots of NFF dignitaries have also come into town, from board members to even Federal House of Representative members of different parts of the states in Nigeria. I mean, a lot of them are coming to cheer the Super Eagles to victory. And a lot of them are also optimistic. Of course, they have to be, I mean, ahead of the quarterfinals. But it's going to be a big clash. And Rigobert Song did say something, which, of course, I picked from the press conference. He's going to respect Nigeria, but he doesn't even believe in history. He wants to create his own history. Yes, he did win it in the past as a player. Yes, he has played Nigeria many times, but he's talking about building his own kind of history right here in the city of Abidjan.
All right, so we'll look forward to that game. That game kicks off in a couple of hours' time, 9 p.m. Nigerian time, to be precise. And for the Nigerian fans, they're all optimistic that Nigeria can pick a win over Cameroon. But a lot of the fans are also thinking this Super Eagles will not go further than today.
Lots of fans are thinking if they can go further than this. And of course, I have a fan who is right here with me. He'll be talking about what to expect from today's game. And quickly, bonjour to you.
Thank you. Good morning.
All right, good morning. What's your name?
I am Alex Michael Tano. I am agronomist.
Where are you from?
I am from Cameroon.
Okay.
Yes, I am from Yaoundé. I came in Cote d'Ivoire to promote agriculture through the football.
All right, let's talk about the game. Cameroon takes on Nigeria today. You're a Cameroonian. Yes, I know you want to support Cameroon, but let me hear from you. What do you think will happen in this game?
About this game, you know, you are our neighbors, Cameroon and Nigeria are the neighbors. So I think Cameroon can do the best. You know, we are the good nation. We are the nation of football. And we think that it will be the big match today. And we think Rigobertson and his player can do more to get the victory.
All right. Now say something in French. Your life right here in from Abidjan and in Nigeria. Say something in French to you know, wish your team success.
Okay, cher frère Nigérian, je sais que vous supportez bien évidemment le Nigeria. Nous sommes des voisins. Je suis Camerounais et fier de l'être. Je sais que le match sera assez élevé. Okay. Ben, je pense que Rigobertson et ses Rigobert Song et ses coéquipiers, ses joueurs donneront le meilleur d'eux-mêmes pour qu'on ait vraiment un bon match, quoi.
All right, so just quickly for those that don't understand, just in space of 10 seconds, tell us the meaning of what you said.
Okay, comme je disais tantôt, je suis en Côte d'Ivoire.
In English.
Oui, I am in Côte d'Ivoire to promote agriculture through the football.
Okay.
Candidate, the project is candidate.
All right, anyways, a lot of things are happening right here. So many persons are taking advantage of the African Cup of Nations, but nevertheless, it's just the spirit of football as a lot of fans would troop into the stadium. Abidjan. And the good thing is, what I fear for the Super Eagles of Nigeria, yes, they are professionals, but then Nigeria did not have the opportunity to train at match time. Now, Cameroon did train around 8:30 p.m., Nigerian time, 7:30 p.m. Abidjan time, and at the moment, you did want to say that Nigeria have not played, during that kind of time. They've not also trained at that particular time. How would they, acclimatize? But you did want to say also that they are professionals. But for Cameroon, they had the opportunity to train under floodlights yesterday. We'll see how much of that it will bring to the table. And good news for the team. Also, Vison Abubakar is back into the team, and he may likely start for Cameroon ahead of the game against the Super Eagles of Nigeria.